The exciting new way to make an everyday hairstyle come alive like magic.
Let me. I need the practice. It's never too soon to start.
Catch the madness. It's mall madness.
Attention mall shoppers.
Hi, I'm Polly Pocket.
It's time for Meg Reacts.
Welcome, everybody, to Meg Reacts. I know Megan is so happy to be joining me today.
I love you.
I gotta get mine in first because you're gonna be ribbing into me once we get this episode started.
No, no.
Because I am not looking forward to the content of this video.
Ooh.
But is, and if I'm not looking forward to it, you want to take a guess as to what it is?
It's gotta be something with boy bands.
You are absolutely right.
Yes.
It is 90s music.
Okay.
And Meg knows this, and I believe we've talked about this before. I am a rock and roll heavy metal guy, and that is it. If it's not that, then I don't want anything to do with it. And the 90s was one of the most difficult times for me musically, because I think every bit of what I'm going to play for Megan, I do not like at all. But this is not Alex Reacts. This is Meg Reacts, and I know that she loves these kinds of things. So I'm going to show you four commercials of different that relate to 90s music.
Okay.
So before we go into these commercials, what are some music? Because you had said earlier in a previous episode that you liked a variety of music.
I did.
Talking about the Barbie boombox. What were some songs or bands and singers and performers that you liked in the 90s?
I was very much into boy bands. So the Backstreet Boys were my favorite band of all time.
Were?
That has not changed.
I didn't think that had changed.
I mean, I love them to this day. I mean, I don't really have a particular like favorite band or this. Mm-hmm. I just kind of love music all in general. But yeah, Backstreet Boys were my all-time favorite. Still my favorite boy band to this day. And they are still going strong. And I liked NSYNC, of course. 98 Degrees. LFO. 5. I was a Spice Girls fan. Sorry, honey.
Yeah.
Girl power. Whatever. I don't care about that crap. But
but that was the thing. That was what they did all the
time.
Were
girl
power.
Girl power. And I mean, yay, but I was just like the music.
But also, that was really the first time a lot of girls ever heard anything like that. So.
Yes. That I can understand why they were like revolutionary in bringing that out because. You had them, but then you also had TLC. I loved, I very much into R&B bands as well, like Genuine, Michael...
Jordan.
Montel Jordan. That's it. Aha. Told you I'd think of it. But I was, very much into those. I also listened to a lot of solo singers, too. Celine Dion was big in the 90s, Mariah Carey, Will Smith. I liked listening to even rap as well, so... I listen to a wide range of music.
Well, then let's just dive into these four commercials and see which of these you remember.
Okay. My favorite to start off.
You knew from the start. And now, so do a million others.
Quit playing games with my heart.
Backstreet Boys, their debut album featuring the smash single Quit Playing Games With My Heart and their brand new hit As Long As You Love Me. You must be 18 or older to order.
Love the Backstreet Boys.
Their debut album.
Wow. Well, they formed in 1992 and I believe Nick Carter was only like 12 years old at the time when they formed, and now he's in his 40s. So that's pretty awesome. I got to give them credit for being able to stay together this long and continue and just still they have kids that knew them in the 90s that have their own kids now, and they're seeing them, and it's just, that's just awesome. As Long As You Love Me, I remember that video. I probably watched that on repeat several times because I used to love the chair sequence they did where they danced with the fold-out chairs. Those were my favorite bits. But yes, Backstreet Boys, all-time favorite. I did get to go see them in concert for the very first time in 2019. Then with my mom, because my mom is also a huge fan of theirs, which is awesome considering there were after her time of being a teenager, but she absolutely loves them to death.
Yeah, we were afraid to get you guys front row seats because,
oh my gosh, she I probably would have passed out
because, well, not you, your mom would have been escorted out. Yeah, because she would have tried to get on the stage.
Oh,
and
my lord,
which one would she try to tackle?
AJ. She is obsessed with him. I'm like, Mom, he's old enough to be your son. And she's like, so? That'll mean nothing? I was like, man. She, yeah.
You're not doing Kentucky any favors, Mom.
No. But it was one of the, I mean, I had dreamed about going to see them in concert since I was a kid. So getting to actually have that come true and getting to experience that was the best thing ever. It was such a great concert. They sound incredible. And I know they sang live. They don't ever lip sync at any of their concerts. And they just sounded phenomenal. Even to this day, they don't even sound... I mean, they sound different because they're older, but not much different.
Still harmonized well.
Very, very good harmony. So, yeah. All right. I'm ready to go see them again.
All right, next one.
Okay.
When it comes to the music of the 90s, anything goes. Right here, right now.
Music today is everywhere. No need to label it. If it's good, we'll play it.
That's why we got Living in the 90s. 2.5 hours of the coolest songs on 2 CDs and 2 cassettes.
Check it out.
You can't touch this.
There's only one thing left to say about living in the 90s.
You're unbelievable.
To order, call the number on your screen or send check or money order. 2 CDs, $26.99. 2 cassettes, $21.99. Rush delivery available. Living in the 90s is not sold in stores.
Wow, I remember those commercials.
Yeah, those compilation albums.
Oh my gosh. They still make compilation albums today.
They do, but they don't really advertise them like this anymore.
No, they air during like the early wee hours of the morning when everyone's mostly asleep. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, and it's mostly older music. older music.
Yeah, because this was the thing, especially early 90s. It was always those call this number, pay for shipping and handling. And in the early 90s, it was like, oh, sorry, no CODs. Okay. They seemed to stop that. But they had this like pure disco and pure funk. Mm-hmm. And
this was the beginning of the, now that's what I call music, mm-hmm, CDs that they started releasing, like the now and then album number, whatever we're at now. But... Mm-hmm. That was essentially, I think, what got that going, because everyone was like, I just want a CD that's got like a big mix of everything. And this was before you could download music and burn it like you could in the 2000s.
Napster.
Yep. Yeah. So this was huge. This was like the first, well.
Now this particular album.
Yeah,
because this isn't boy bands. This is almost like a collection of a
very big, huge collection
of like one hit, mostly one hit wonders. Not all of them.
Well,
but most a of, lot them were. Of them. Yeah. Is this something that would have interested you as a kid?
Probably not as a kid. Now, yeah, because I listened to it as I got older, mm-hmm, especially when I started hitting like 12 and 13 years old, I remember them. But as like a 7, 8 year, like Sam's age, probably not. No. Mm-hmm. A lot of the songs on that were not in the particular genre of music that I was listening to. But I mean, I know them. I very much know them.
Yeah, they were powerhouses. Everyone knew those songs.
Yeah.
Whether you liked them or not, you heard those songs.
I mean, gosh, Ice Ice Baby was like, it was everywhere. And, oh man, Marky Mark and the Funky Bunch. Yeah, that song, Good Vibrations. I mean, that's, yeah. Those were pretty much one-hit wonders. Because, mm-hmm. I mean, I don't remember a lot of... Well, Roxette had some hits. You mm-hmm. know, they had other more that they did.
And Will Smith. Fresh Prince and DJ Jazzy yes. Jeff. They were on the list
they
as well.
They were on the list, but they... Yeah.
They weren't one-hits. They had quite a few pretty good success songs for yeah. them.
MC Hammer.
But Summertime was probably their biggest one at this time of this album.
MC Hammer. I mean, you think MC Hammer, you always think of... You can't touch this.
No, I think of Hammerman. Don't go look for Hammerman. Don't.
Yeah.
All right. Next.
Are you ready? For now, 17 of today's hottest superstars in one all-new Power Pack collection. Move into a new dimension with the year's biggest songs.
I don't care who you are, where you're from.
Now you can have all your favorite hits right here, right now. Chart toppers from KZ and JoJo, Aqua, Brian McKnight, Janet, and Spice Girls. Now delivers nothing but the biggest hits you crave. But to get them, call the number on your screen. There's never been a music collection like this before, until now. On CD or cassette. To order, call the number on your screen or send check or money order for the amount shown plus shipping and handling. Must be 18 or older to call.
Yeah, that was the only way you could get them was ordering them, because this was before they put them in stores at Walmart. Mm-hmm. Now you can just buy them in Walmart. Well, not so much anymore now, but... Gosh, so, now it's funny. I was like, that's funny. I was just mm-hmm. talking about that.
She had no idea what commercials I've got no. paid for.
Oh my gosh.
So when this came out, would you have wanted this one?
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. I would have.
Do you want this one now?
Sure. I would. If you can find them, I wonder if you can still find them online.
Oh yeah. You can find them on eBay, I'm sure.
I'd like to go back and get a lot of the first ones that came out, because they have all the mixture of songs. And it would just save me time. But I have a couple of now CDs that I bought in the 2000s. So
I had to look to see how far into now albums we are.
Oh, God. What is it, like 82 or something?
Mm. Well, according to just doing on Amazon, it's got 113. 2022.
Okay, so this was last year's. Okay. Yeah, I would have definitely wanted that, because, I mean, it had, I mean, a lot of great songs that I, and a lot of those songs that they advertised were in, like, popular movies in the 90s.
Oh,
like,
yeah. And a lot of these bands ended up being on All That.
Oh, gosh, yes. That was actually where I heard a lot of artists that I maybe didn't know as much of. Mm-hmm. And it was from watching All That, mm-hmm. seeing and watching the musical guests, because I used to look forward to that, like, who's gonna be on, who's gonna be on, who's gonna be on. So like every time I'd watch the credits and they'd show who the musical guest was, and it was like, because it was always, if it was a boy band or if it was TLC or Spice Girls or anything, it was like.
All right, last one. I can do this, I can do this, I can do this. Come and get
your love. Turn on to the hottest sounds of the 90s. Get your love. Baby, the stars are shining for you. It's Totally 90s. The most explosive collection of 90s hits ever. Don't turn around. Ace of Base. You can't change the way. 36 non-stop hits. Are you strong? Over 2 hours of the freshest sounds of the decade. The original Macarena.
groove to the music of your favorite 90s stars. Totally 90s on two CDs or two cassettes. You won't find this one in any store. To order, call the number on your screen or send check or money order for $21.99 for two cassettes or $26.99 for two CDs plus shipping and handling. Must be 18 or older to call.
I mean, it was just another compilation CD, just like the Now music was.
Now, this one, much like the Living in the 90s, it wasn't quite your thing when this came out. As an adult, you know, you want Now. Living in the 90s, you would probably like Now. What about this one?
Oh, yeah.
There was Montel Jordan, Amy Grant.
Oh, Amy Grant. Yeah, baby, baby. That was... I used to listen to that with my mom, because we loved Amy Grant.
Sheryl Crow.
Didn't really listen to Sheryl Crow that much, but and Amy Grant's a Christian singer,
I listened to Sheryl Crow all the time when in the 90s. In 97, she did a James Bond
Ace
cover.
Ace of Spades, yes. James Bond song. Ace of Spades did that. I saw the sun. Yeah, let's see who else is on here.
Gin Blossoms, Montel Jordan, which you had just
mentioned. Yes.
Fears for Tears.
Shoot, let's see. Lionel Richie. Bump and Grind. I mentioned that one because I used to love that song.
What about the Macarena?
Yes.
Everyone knows that one.
I mean, well, it goes to show how popular that song still even gets around, considering it was a one-hit wonder, because even Sam likes that song now because of watching Hotel Transylvania.
Yeah, they still find a place to put that.
And he loves it.
Oh, Macarena, Macarena, Macarena. Oh, Macarena, Macarena, Macarena. Oh, I hate the Macarena.
That was like the Gangnam Style dance that came out later on. And the or the Electric Slide, that was a big one that came
electric
out.
Electric Slide I can handle.
R. Kelly had some good slow jams that were a little probably not appropriate for my age, but you listened to them because you didn't know any better.
You just didn't care.
It's sad to say, because it goes to show you how much you change and how when you become a parent. Because as I was telling a friend the other day, I said Ludacris came on the radio and it was that I Want to Lick You from Your Head to Your Toe. And I was like, oh, this is my jam. I love this song. And I was like, oh my gosh. I just heard the lyrics in this song, really realized what the lyrics were saying in this song. And I'm like, I can't believe I used to listen to this and get away with it. But then I thought, I don't think my mother actually knew I was listening to this. My brother probably did, but you know, it just makes you go, God, you know, you're listening to today's music going, I never let my child listen to this. This is all they talk about is women's butts and body parts and this, and it's like, oh.
That is going to do it for this episode of Meg Reacts. I believe we only have one left for this season. What was some of your favorite 90s bands/singers and performers? Let us know down below. You can also send us an email over at splatattack2021@gmail.com. Please like, subscribe, share this with your friends. Share this with some of your friends who love 90s music and help them remember how awesome some of these songs were.
I still listen to them today. Like, I
don't take my word for it. Take this one. She's the one who appreciates it.
I have a playlist started on Spotify that's strictly 90s music. Because I just don't think the music today will ever compare to it. I feel like it hits differently with me. And I'm pretty wide range in different genres and even in decades too. I like different style decades of music, but it's just something about the 90s that just hits more. Like, I guess it was just because it was my time. That was, you know, that's why.
It's your nostalgia.
So, yeah, I miss it. It's hard to, sometimes it's hard to, where you're at today going, gosh, I miss the music. I miss the times. 90s were just such a great time, especially to be a kid. It was a good time.
All right, 90s kids, thank you guys for tuning in. Tuning in music. And we will see you guys next month. Splat, you're like, oh.
Yes, that's French they're speaking. And no, these children aren't French. They're American.
Oh, no, it's Mr. Gruder's house! Not the wind!
You hit it, you get it!
That's just what I wanted to know.
Order yours today.
You knew from the start. And now, so do a million others.
Quit playing games with my heart.
Backstreet Boys, their debut album, featuring the smash single, Quit Playing Games with My Heart, and their brand new hit, As Long As You Love Me. You must be 18 or older to order.